I belong to the backward region of Marathwada, which is a part of Maharashtra state of India. I was born and brought in this region. My ancestral village is Murum district, Usmanabad. This is a small tiny village. And we are basically middle class family, a sort of joint family. But my part of India was under the influence and rule of Nizam state. So we are mingled with the Muslim culture, Urdu culture. It is called Ganga Jamni Tazdeeb. So the best of both Hindu culture and Muslim culture. And so I was born and brought on this background. My father was in bank service. He was working in State Bank of Hyderabad. And he was moving from one place to another place. Mostly in the region of Marathwada and some part of Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka region. Because that part is very homogeneous, where the language of Marathi, Kannada and Telugu are intermixed. So I was brought in this multi-ethnic and multi-linguistic culture. I was born in Nanded city when my father was posted there, and my initial education, school education, was in Usmanabad district, in local body, Jilla Parishad school. And for my graduation, I again came to Nanded when my father was posted there. So I did my BSc in chemistry, and I also did my postgraduate course, MSc course in inorganic chemistry from Marathwada University, Aurangabad. My region was ruled by Maharaja Nizam. Nizam was a princely state, consisting of some part of Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra and Karnataka. It was ruled for more than 300 years, and it was a Muslim state. But the majority ward is Hindu people. 90% of the population is Hindu people, only 10% are ruling class of Muslim people. So that was the culture. And he tried to enforce the Urdu culture, Muslim culture in a great way in all spheres of the social life of that region. So we were exposed to Islamic culture to a great extent. My father was just matriculated. He did his matriculation from Banaras, of Uttar Pradesh, and he joined as a cashier cum clerk in State Bank of Hyderabad. My mother is housewife. She was not much literate, but she is very voracious leader. She was fond of reading, and till her last breath she was reading mostly Marathi literature and partly Hindi literature. Because of my mother's inclination toward literature and art, I was exposed to the world of the books. I can add one incident when I was at Usmanabad, my mother used to go to local library to bring books for reading. But because of her house or chorus, she did not find much time to go to the library regularly. So one fine day, she took me. I was at that time studying in 7th standard of school, just 10 or 11 year old, and she took me to the library, introduced to the librarian, and told the librarian that henceforth my son will come. I'll give some books, I'll report some books, so please give the book for reading. So from that day, I was going to the library to bring book for my mother initially. Then slowly I started reading, I have given me this, why my mother is reading? Then I asked mother, tell the story, what is written in the books. So she told some stories from the books. I got interested and she encouraged me to read. You can read yourself, now you can also read her. So she first introduced me to the children literature, the slowly young adult literature, and then the normal literature. So I started reading, I became voracious reader. Then because of my education, Hindi, English. I started reading Hindi, English also. So that was the boon of my mother. Give my mother that I am not a writer today. I have three sisters and one brother. All are settled in Maharashtra at various places. I have two sisters in Mumbai, one sister in Pune, and brother is also in working as a bank officer. So this is my career. From the school days, I started writing mostly short stories and poems. They get published, so I encourage. When I reached, I entered the college life. I become very serious about writing because of my exposure to vast reading and good friends, some stalwarts in the literature field. They encouraged me to write books. So I started writing short stories basically, and I find that I am basically a fiction writer. I am not a poet. Initially I wrote some few poems. Everybody write poems in youth days. But I thought that stories and novels is my forte, where I am very comfortable. And what I am visualize is the only form of the stories or novels. So I started but because of tradition in Maharashtra, who scored good marks in matriculation or school level education, they go for engineering or science, doctor, medical profession. So my father sent me to science college to learn with the hope that I should get good marks and enter medical profession. I was meritorious students throughout my career from matriculation to postgraduate, except that 12th standard, from on basis of which I should get admission either medical or engineering college. But because of that year, I was interested, I did so many things, extra the activity like editing school magazine, college magazine, participating in the gatherings, sports, all those things. So I, though I scored good marks, it was not good enough to enter medical college. Though I got admission to engineering college. During college life, I turned to literature in big way, reading and writing. When I was in my postgraduate MSc in first year, already I published four novels. Two are detective, two are social novels in Marathi language. Basically, I am Marathi speaking person, Marathi language state, language of Maharashtra state. I write mostly Marathi, occasionally in English. And I got really good response from readers and critics. It gave me impetus that I should pursue this career very badly. But in India, except English language writers, no vernacular writer language can live on solely on the writing, because the sale of books in vernacular language is limited to that state, and people are not much fond of purchasing books and reading. So it can't be a career for livelihood. So in India, mostly writers take some profession, some for the livelihood, and they also write in their spare times. Similarly, I thought that I should do some work for livelihood. Initially, I joined banking service as per my father's advice. It was very lucrative. It is giving good money also. But I was after some 1 or 2 years, after 2 years, I found that it is a very boring job. So it is not interesting to me, because I am an extrovert person and I am socially committed. Because in college days, I joined the youth movements of Maharashtra. It is called Yuvak Kranti Dal. It is youth revolutionary front, and they are doing some social service. And it reminded me that we have some commitment to our society. How north and down to the people, and we should do something, we should devote our some part energy and do some work. So that was the impression in my mind, and I want to do such things where I can help people in big way. There are only two choices. I should be full time worker or join some NGO or some political front, but that is not the cup of my tea. So another, what is another thing? I should join administrative services, in administrative service, where I can deliver, because these services are basically for the delivery, of the welfare schemes. So there I can make some difference. So I appear for computer examinations. I enter the administrative services in 1984-85, and since last 30 years I was administrator at basic field level, because I am interested in field level posting. Well, I can make actual difference to downtown people. If I was sitting at state level, secretary level, and follow only policy there. But implementation of policy is much more important. In last 30 years, I can say, if I look back, I can say with satisfaction that I did by level best to do the things. At all my postings, I work in 15 to 16 places in Maharashtra. I delivered that, and people still remember. I always believe in the response administration, also out of box ideas. Within that power given to me by the statute and law, I can formulate some new things and did my level best. What I can say is I did great work, and pioneer work nobody has done in India is about the stopping of female feticide. When I was collector of Kolhapur, employed the use of IT services for this purpose. I started the campaign Save the Baby Girl. As I told earlier, that since my childhood, I started reading to great extent, and a voice reader automatically turned to writer. That is the worldwide experience. So I started writing in my school days. I still remember that my first poem and first short story, children's story, was published when I was just 10 year old. And it was, I got some remuneration for that, 5 rupees. It was great for me at that time. It gave me encouragement, so I wrote a few children's stories and poems. And then I still turned to write short stories, adult stories. And when I entered college, I started writing seriously. It was a hobby in the child in the school children. But when I entered college, it was a vast horizon, and I started writing career with keen interest and seriously. Basically, I am a woman worshipper. I can believe in great strength of a woman. I was greatly influenced by my mother. What I am today, if I am successful to some extent, it is the boon of my mother, because she imbibed in me the great values of equality in me. She never differed between me and my sisters. She said that as you are my son, they are my daughters, they are I'm also part of my daughter. So, because of my mother, I believe greatly in the woman equality, men-woman equality, and I'm the champion of women's rights from the beginning. When I get married, my wife Anjali, she was a graduate, she did her BSc in science, but she helped from the lawyer's family. Her father, her grandfather, her uncles are practicing advocates in Nanded district, and she had desired that she should also do her LLB, a law course, and start practice to enter the legal professions. So after marriage and birth of my son, she take break up 5 years, and now when my son become old enough, she joined law course. Aurangabad has a high court, so she started practicing high court. And she was very successful at that time. She filed 2-3 public interest litigations and won also. And her court is a woman's cause. She fought for women's power in divorce cases, in other related issues, violence, all those things. And she also did some female cases also. She achieved a lot. So though she hailed from a small taluka place, a small village, and she never visited Mumbai or Pune before marriage. Her journey from a working homely woman to a district judge rank officer is really amazing. It is very simple. I was also encouraged, but though I encouraged, but I can say that it is her own achievement. Just I supported, I appreciated her role, her determination, because she has that talent. And she is so successful in Pune and Aurangabad that I am really amazed. And she delivered so many judgments. And we are planning to write books of our case studies. Here she gave judgment and which are confirmed by the state and national commissions and Supreme Court. In India, we should not go for more than one children. That is my personal belief. As an administrator, we are propagating family planning. So, I thought we decided that our first issue is our last issue. That is the only issue. I got son, but I really wanted a daughter. We are here living, myself, my mother, my wife, my children, my daughter-in-law. And she got selected for the postcard president and posted to Aurangabad. So not a single moment I thought that I should oppose it. And she also had that confidence that she will go there, live alone there and do the job. So that is also one thing I can say proudly. Because of it is not a sacrifice. It is not something I have done great favor to my wife. It is very natural because she is also intelligent, you know, she is also qualified. As in my inclination and my firm belief, all my women characters are very strong. Though they are lively, they have their own weaknesses. Ultimately, they have the strength to overcome the odds. So my first story was against dowry. Published in one good magazine and it was appreciated by that. Then there are very story writing competitions of various magazines and newspapers. In Maharashtra, the tradition of the Diwali issues, the yearly issues, and they announced the 3-4 month in advance story competition. I started used to send stories by to such competition, and in 1 year I got first or second prize in those competition in 5 magazines and 5 stories are published in various magazines. That gave me great encouragement and some name. And then there was no looking back. After a few writing, stories around 2025, I said 10 stories and published one first books, Marathi books. Of Star Story Collection, it is called Kathanjali. So it is a bouquet of different type of star stories. All are different genre. Some are serious, some are light-hearted, some love stories, some serious social issues. So these are combined. And it got first prize at the state level. So then as regular writing, I was seeing that 1985, and till today I have published more than 25 books, 21 Marathi and 4 English books, and I got so many awards, literature and state awards for these people, and I also wrote one children's play. I also wrote non-fiction books, 3-4 books. Basically my forte is novels and short stories. Another book I have tackled is about child labor. That was my concern. It is about the last childhood. Another is on the female feticide. So then water scarcity and famine. So I basically I'm interested in the tackling the social problems through the novels in fictional format. So I work as a collector, I was working as a chief executive officer, Jilla Panchayat, local bodies, I was municipal commissioner. And these are very hectic posting, I had to work there 10 to 12 hours per day. But apart from that, I am early riser. So each day, I am wake up at 4 o'clock and I read up to 7 o'clock. That is my daily routine, at least 4 to 5 days in one week. And when there is a holiday like Sunday or some other holidays, I am use that period for writing. I have no other interest except writing. That is my passion. I have only two passions. One is administration, because I want to bring changes in the life of the down-to-the-ground people, have nots. That is my passion. And for that purpose, leaving the bank, I left the bank service and joined administrative services. And I did my administration with the sensitive mind. I always use my instinct and my empathy toward the poor people in doing administration. My cornerstone is that the charisma of Mahatma Gandhi, who told us that we have to wipe the tears of the downtrodden people. That is my philosophy of my administration. So I am doing that. I can make so many human stories which are very interesting. And because of bureaucratic setup and our crude behavior of many bureaucrats and lower rank machinery, we are not sensitive enough to the problems of the people. But because of my background, my thinking, I have that knack or that sensitive mind to see the problems of people. So I was successful because I was empathizing with the human suffering. So, and that gave me many story ideas. When I hit those ideas, it was a compelling for me to write. So I'm writing it. I always say with pride that administration, doing justice to people, and writing are the two points of my personality. You can't separate my writing from my administration. You can't separate my administration from writing. Because if I am successful administrator, because I am a writer, that means that as a writer, I can understand the human suffering. So that I use that quality of mine dealing with administration. If I listen to their problems, I instantly connect with their suffering, their problem. And then there was urge in my mind, that is my instinct, that I should help them. If they are suffering and if I have authority, power, resources, I must help him. I was posted as collector Kolhapur in 2002-2009. I was there for 3.5 years. Collector is the main district posting for any administrative officers. He is the representative of the government at district level. And he has all powers to summon all other departments. He is the basic look after law and order and coordination and implementation of the various welfare schemes. In fact, he do anything and everything if he desires so in that given powers. So, in Kolhapur, I came across so many social issues like female feticide, black marketing, stopping black marketing things. Kolhapur was a great cultural hub. Kolhapur has a great history. It was the birthplace of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. He was a great social reformer and he was a princely ruler. Any person go to Kolhapur, he can't escape from the presence and thinking of Shivaji Maharaj. So, and naturally, I'm become a visitor. I know about his work. But when I posted to Kolhapur, I started reading his books in a great extent. And he did many pioneering works like women's education, reservation of downtrodden people, and abolition of the slavery, abolition of the untouchability. So he was a really great king in true sense. And while reading his history and the history of the Shaho dynasty, I came across one really remarkable chapter in history of Kolhapur, that during the Second World War, more than 5,000 Polish women and children came to stay in Kolhapur, Prince State, at a place called Valivade. They came in the 1943, and the last batch of Polish refugees settled in Valivade left in 1948. So during those 4.5 years or 5 years, they live in harmony with the local people. There are many stories I came across about their mixing with the local people and developing a strong relationship with our local people. It fascinated me. So I dwell into in depth, and I studied the history of Poland, read the history of Poland, and came to know that after attack from Germany and Soviet Union at that time, many Polish people were deported to Siberia in Soviet Union for manual work, and their women and children were sent to Kazakhstan for toiling. And after general amnesty because of pressure from the America and Britain people, and when Stalin joined Britain to fight against the Germany, Nazi Germany, because of their pressure, Stalin or Soviet Union declared general amnesty. And out of 30 lakhs people, 3 million people who was deported to Soviet Union, nearly 1 lakh people were settled in various colonies of the Britain. And some came to Valivade. I came to know that by reading the history of Poland, I came to know that initially around 1,000 children, Polish children, were adopted by Maharaja Jamnagar Singh Ji, and they are sitting in the Balachadi. And that put pressure on the British regime to settle other Polish refugees in their colonies, and they selected Valivade as a good place for their settlement, and they built one whole village, barracks, in that village. And in 1943, in two or three batches from Karachi, these people came by roads to Iraq, Iran, and they settled there. And that when I came to know about their settlement in Valivade, I visited Valivade. There was no sign of that period except that Kabrastana monastery. I came across a few peoples who know about that past history. I came across with Miss Wanda Kashikar, wife of Vasant Kashikar, who was a Polish girl at that time, and she fell in love with Mr. Vasant Kashikar and married to that person and lived in Kolhapur till her last breath. So that story fascinated me, and as a writer, I thought it was a very challenging subject for me as a creative writer. How those Polish people coming from Poland, such a long journey through Siberia and through Kazakhstan, how they reached to Valivade or Kolhapur princely state, and what are their sufferings, how they face some odds mixing with local people. You know, it is a very alien culture, alien country. And those women, basically they are homely wives, they never go out of their homes or their country. They have to take such a long journey and came to India. So that human element excited me to get something. I thought this is a very good subject for novel. So I collected material, came across so many life stories of Polish people who spent their 4 years in Kolhapur. And then I thought that instead of writing a factual story, if I can take the larger picture of their suffering, I thought that it is better to write a fictional story, but based on the facts. So I started writing, I did my research, And then third thing, instead of writing, if I can produce film or write a screenplay for the film, it is better. And during that period, I was a main director of the film city, Mumbai, as an officer. And there a Polish ambassador of India came for some work and visited film city. I just mentioned to him about this. And he also liked that idea. And that encouraged me to write the screenplay. And then with the help of one good Indian producer who was interested in this subject, and also Shyam Menegal showing interest in the story angle, I wrote down the screenplay. When I was in Kolhapur, I started to get more information about the that period of Polish settlement. I came across that Miss Wanda Kashikar, or she was called Kashikar, who married to a Hindu person from the Kolhapur. I met her many times and heard her story. And through her, I got the books published by Polish government documenting the that part, refugee part. So, and through net and some research book, my interaction with the Wanda Kashikar and few persons in the Kolhapur who remember that period. Now they are in old stage. They are very common people, but they are telling I was a carpenter, I was supplying some food items, and was truck driver, all those things. So that is one. So I got some knowledge, and there was a visit of Polish people last year, which I read through newspaper and news items, and based on all these things, I also got some information, some memories of Polish refugees on net. Coming and reading all those things, as a writer, I visualized what happened at that time. I wrote one fictional story, but based on the facts, what happened, how they migrated, deported to Siberia and Kazakhstan, how they came and reached to India, and how they live here. And the history of that Kolhapur during that period, 1942 to 48, I am highlighted a few major incidents that is, and in relation to Poland people, how they are came across with the local people, how Wanda is meeting Vasant and meeting him at Mahalakshmi temple, and then local culture like football, films, music, and other things. So I created, I visualized all those things, and that was one good story, Roads to Freedom. When I hit upon the idea that instead of writing novel, I should write screenplay for the film, because I was MD Film City, I know there are many opportunities where with good script, if I came with good script, I can get good producer from India and Poland also. So I just mentioned the idea, this idea to one Indian producer, Mr. Nitin Chandrakant Desai. He's a well-known art director and Marathi film producer, TV serial producer. He liked the idea to create the, because he's an art director, and he realized that I had to create in the film the Kolhapur city of 1940s. He got excited about the idea. And he argued that I should find good producer, good director to do justice to this film. And while discussing with my friends, I jotted down 2-3 names. But finally, I thought that Mr. Shyam Menegal, who did so many historical films like Discovery of India, Netaji Subhash, films on Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Junoon on the 1857 war, he had a great sense of history during the 19th century. So I just I met him, I mentioned about this film, and I told him the idea of the story. He liked that story. I think that it is very representative of that period to depict the suffering of Polish people and their courage, their determination, and their liveliness in spite of all adversities, and their adaptability to the Alien culture, alien land, that is the great history. Equally, it is important from India, from Indian perspective, that we have hosted these people and treat them as equal, because they also are sufferer, we are also sufferer, because India was at that time under the British regime. We are also tortured a lot by these people. And similarly, at the hands of the Soviet Union and Germany, Poland was sufferer. So it was a mutual sympathy or empathy of two sufferer communities, or two suffering nations. And because of Uma Devi, who was instrumental in raising awareness about the Polish plights and involvement of support of Mahatma Gandhi, it was people treated Polish refugees as their equals and adopted, accepted their presence in India gracefully, and they helped a lot. So that from that angle, both from India and Poland, it is equally important. That is the good part on both Poland and India. We have bond of suffering, a bond of mutual interest, mutual suffering. So this story should be told to the people of all people of the world. Such thing happened, and it was a great bonding between India and Poland.